Okay guys, welcome to another video. This is gonna be a War Thunder rant, and of course it's gonna be about the Russians, like usual. Let me first explain that I don't know when patch 1.39 is supposed to be out. This video is being recorded currently on the 4th, I mean on the 14th of April 2014, and I don't have my YouTube channel back yet, but if I get it back, this video will be going up there. So what I'm saying is this video may be quite old by the time it's uploaded. War Thunder just announced... well, let me start off with... I'm speaking from a realistic game mode point of view. Not anywhere from the arcade game section of War Thunder. Gaijin just announced that they are releasing a new premium aircraft into War Thunder when patch 1.39 goes live. They say it will only be there for a few days, but that's not the point. A lot of people are going to buy it, and once they do, they will have the plane forever. Gaijin are releasing the Spitfire Mk 9 for the Russian tech tree. Just fucking wonderful. Why does this piss me off? Well... First, this is the sixth Russian event in a row. Sixth! When are we going to see any other country events? When are we going to get any other German pilots, or American pilots, or a Japanese pilot? We never see Japanese pilots. When are we going to see a British pilot event? We're never going to see anything like that. Second, the Russians already have overperforming aircraft, and way too many of them. They don't need any more. The Spitfire Mk 9 has an overperforming climb rate, like a lot of other aircraft in the game. Giving it to the Russians isn't going to do anything but make more retards fly it because they think they are masters at the game. Sure, a good pilot can make a bad plane great, but when you get a bad pilot to fly a broken aircraft, they don't need to be good at the game, even for a realistic battle. It is hard to fly Axis powers at mid to high tier because of a lot of different aircraft that have broken flight models, things like the F-8F Bearcat, the I-185, various Yaks, the Spitfire Mk 9, and many others. It doesn't matter what nation I choose to fly, I always get one of a fucking alternate history maps. 95% of the time, it is fucking alternate Berlin. And when I fly Germans, I rarely ever see battles with Americans or British. And when I fly Japanese, 98% of the time, I'm going against the fucking Russians. Because, you know, the Pacific Theater didn't mean anything. I would like to fly realistic battles against nations that actually fought against my own. Not on a fucking alternate history map. It is just fucking bullshit. Now to get on to the point why I don't think the Russians, and I don't want the Russians, to have a Spitfire Mk 9. As I said a bit ago, it is hard to fly Axis powers mid to high tier because of aircraft like the Mk 9. The Russians already have so many broken aircraft. If they get the Spitfire Mk 9, it would be stupid to even play the game and expect to win the times 4 for the day unless you either flew broken aircraft yourself or flew with the Russians. I am always going to hate the Russian aircraft in War Thunder until the ones that need to be fixed are fixed. If the Spitfire Mk 9's flight model was fixed, I wouldn't have a single problem with the Russians getting one. I'm still fucking pissed off that the Americans got one. Sure, historically, this Lend-Lease bullshit made it happen, but this is a fucking video game. Lend-Lease in this game would make sense if they weren't giving each other UFO status aircraft. Now let me pause here for a moment to explain my definition of UFO status aircraft. Actually, let me... There we go. Apologize for that. My definition of UFO status aircraft may be a little bit different from everyone else's. My meaning of UFO is anything that the plane does not do historically correct, or does not perform historically correct. If the plane climbs way too fast, UFO status. If the plane's speed is way too high, UFO status. If the plane maneuvers more than it should, UFO status. And a lot of the aircraft in the game have UFO status. But most of them leak out from the Russian tech tree. I don't feel to add yet another broken premium plane to the list. The P-63 and the P-39 was enough. Both of those aircraft, the P-63 mainly, P-39 not so much, but the P-63 really has an extremely overperforming climb rate and speed. That speed is way too high for the plane itself. I don't believe in this Russian bias that people throw around towards War Thunder because the devs are Russian. I only fucked around about it. But the more they nerf planes in other nations that don't need to be nerfed, and fix planes in other nations that do need to be fixed, but never fix a Russian aircraft, it only makes me think differently about the Russian bias more and more. I'm not someone who is going to completely rage from the game because of it. I'm not like that. Although in the past I have taken a few weeks' worth of breaks due to the Russians, but never stopped playing it altogether. It doesn't help the situation when the stat cards on the aircraft don't mean anything. Turn time and speed don't mean shit. Never trust what the stat card says. I'll give you examples here in a bit. In a minute, I'm going to switch over to the game itself to help show you, with little pictures and said shit about the aircraft. But first, here's some comments from the people on War Thunder main Facebook on War Thunder's main Facebook page. Number one, bloody bollocks, another USSR overpowered plane. Number two, OP Russians, let's just give them everything, lol. Number three, okay, so after the P-63 A-10, Russians get the Spitfire Mark 9 and have all the most cheated premium planes. During this time, Germans only had the FW-190 D-13 in Tier 4. No Russian bias. Number 4. Good to see the Russians getting more OP. Number 5. Oh, come on, why don't you just give a Spit to every fucking nation so they can all tear up my German fighters together? Number 6. Another Russian pilot. Really? Never a German. And why? Oh, the Russians hate the Germans, that's why. Number 7. But no, it's as OP in the British tree as it will ever be in the Russian tree. Mixing up turn fighters in a tree of boom and zoomer just messes with the meta. Look at what happened when the USA got the Spit 9. Number 8. This game is going to be called Spitfires versus P-63s. It'll be nice for the Germans, facing Spitfires from every side. Number 9. You guys running out of ideas? Just add other Russian planes that fought in World War II. Stop giving the Russian tree planes from every other nation. Just because they can't use their own damn planes. We all see your harder Russian ace posts, and how they are only aces because they aren't flying aircraft that you that are made of junk. Air Cobra, King Cobra, and now the Spitfire. It's getting ridiculous, Gaijin. Number 10. And, personally, my favorite. Historically, the Russians did get Spitfires, King Cobras, and other aircraft from Lend-Lease. But might I also add that historically, the Yak-9T's cannon was unreliable, the IL-2 flew like a pig, and the I-185 never left the ground. Stop picking and choosing the realism that only benefits you. It's either all or nothing. The IL-2 in the game flies like a massive UFO, too fast, too maneuverable for anything. The Yak-9T's cannon is not unreliable in the game. And the I-185 has a ridiculous climb rate, ridiculous maneuverability, and ridiculous speed. I'm now going to switch over to the game itself. You may not see this in the Facebook video, but you will see it in the YouTube video. Thanks for watching.